What number is this one?
I don't know the number.
What's up, guys?
Yep, what's up, y'all? I'll have it labeled. I just don't say it no more.
What?
Yeah. This is a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I hope y'all had a good Wednesday. It's 5:32.
Kind of chilly out.
Yep. Rainy. Foggy.
I don't know.
Misty.
We're getting snow somewhere.
Yeah.
At least not here, but yeah.
Shoreline's cresting over and I can feel the sea waves. Oh, no, I'm sorry. That's up around Maine.
Right. Yeah.
I'm sorry. Yeah, it's not mortal.
Yeah.
It's cold and rainy, though, for real.
There we go. A little malfunction there. Yeah.
Yeah. Had a failure to... No.
I hope
that
this be it, yeah.
Of course, we don't want to say the name right off the bat. I know who it is, of course.
Right. They did give the... Banner on the Run, they gave that 5 stars.
They should have.
They did, the Rolling Stone record guy, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He's just in a rare...
What's the
thing? He's in a rare category. You know that, right? Paul is in a rare...
Right. I mean, you know... Oh, yeah, well, they were all individual and different. You know?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. I mean, they're all equal, but... As far as like music wise, artist wise, from a rock and roll, Rolling Stone like point of view, he's in a rare list of artists who just not were in different, like solo number one in a different band number one, but back into another band number one, or even back whatever you know.
Yeah.
There's a few who have, you know, like it's just.
I still eat George Harrison, All Good Things Must Pass.
It's my dad's favorite.
That's an excellent record. That was the best, George Harrison.
That's dad's favorite.
George Harrison, he just... To me, he was,
And he wrote great music, man.
He did,
He just, he really, really did. He was he was a great musician anyways, but he was just...
Right.
He wrote great music.
He contributed, Lennon and McCartney. Well, I think that's like with Revolver. That's a good record.
Yeah. It would be the equivalent of Tesla and Einstein and some of your early scientists like hanging out, you know.
Right.
Da Vinci even, you know, it's like... As far as a super group band, like super icons that come out of that band, you know. Eagles produced some iconic different.
Glenn Frey, Don Henley. You'd have Timothy B. Schmidt, and then that one guy left. Randy Meisner left, and Joe Walker plays Randy Meisner.
Can I tell you something? As far as like modern musician, alternative rock, like, I'm not saying anything, but Chris Cornell, in that genre of an era of music, they started to bring back these rock guys from like Eddie Vedder to whatever, they started mixing up to where they went to supergroup, Rage Against the Machines musicians paired up with Soundgarden's lead singer, which is Chris Cornell, and made Audioslave.
Right.
You know?
Oh, yeah.
Soundgarden, Audioslave. Like a Stone Temple Pilots with Scott Weiland.
Right.
Then he went on to do Velvet Revolver with Slash. Yeah. You know, he branched up.
I read about them in the Rolling Stone magazine.
Yeah. They were good, man. They were good. Yeah, they were good. Scott just had problems with he was having it, and I know he's passed away now, rest his soul, because he was great, but he just struggled getting to rehearsals and stuff, MTV did a documentary it was VH1, one of those, Axis, something like that, did a documentary on how they first met up and started to make this group, they actually had Falling Down, that was the number one top hit. That's when he was with Roseanne or Arquette, whatever.
Right.
Patricia Arquette or something.
Arquette girl, We look like a damn longshoreman with your beanie on and your...
That's why I said I feel the shoreline crest.
Well. Not that cold
now. No, but I'm prepared. Huh. If I took it off now, it look like I've been electrocuted.
Right? Oh, yeah. Like, or you rubbed a balloon on your head.
Look like, yeah, look like one of the little things I've been raised.
Well, just like when that one guy announced he's going to run for president.
Bernie.
And then they showed a picture of years ago. The only difference is his hair was all messed up.
You're talking about Bernie.
Good luck to him.
By the way, I don't know if you know this or not, breaking news before I left. MSNBC reported that in the last 24 hours since he's announced officially he's running, he's raised $6 million on his own. Yeah. And he has nobody give no more than like $100 at a time. He's not big money.
Right.
Yeah. This is a good song, man. I remember doing this song growing up.
Oh, yeah. Don't tell Ronnie. Good Ronnie. I want to hear on your, you have the reflection on your thing?
What?
On your radio.
What?
I want to hear Ram.
Ram?
Yeah. Because when I was a kid, you know, I found a cassette tape on the side of the road. It was kind of unraveled, you know? So I took it home, got a pencil, and I wound it up.
Uh-huh.
And someone had taped that record. The Ram, you know, Hulk Albert and all that.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
I haven't heard it. Yeah, Paul McCartney.
Yeah.
I think that was his first solo record.
Yeah. That's a good album, yeah.
I haven't heard it in years, but yeah.
Oh, man.
What are you doing?
Sneezing.
Well, you gotta pop your drugs, dude.
Nothing there, man. There's nothing there. I've gotten good.
Well, I gotta say,
what would be the hint if they didn't know for the younger kids?
What's that?
Because they might have Googled it now, some of the younger kids, the hint for this band. Without giving it away, what would you say it is? Because that's your territory.
Oh, yeah, okay. Hello, Eric.
But don't give it away, yeah.
No, Aereo.
Yeah.
Because that's,
obviously, yeah.
Right, that's what.
Yeah.
On anything, a bird or an airplane or
a bird. A bird has.
What? Right.
That's back when people would be roller skating.
Sure. Running today, or?
Nope. Oh. I didn't get out in this mess. I would have. Somebody wanted me to wash the car. We bring it up in there to the shop.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, freezing or not. You come in and bring it on in.
Yeah.
Get a running start. I can't guarantee you won't hit the side.
Well,
right.
Well,
yeah.
Well, that was a quiet day at work for me. Yeah.
Was it? Yeah.
Well, two women cutting gloves, and the two women are sorting the bales.
So what'd you have to do?
Watch TV. change a unit pack every now and then. Yeah.
Oh, where it packs the stuff up. Make a bale. Yeah.
No, well, they're sorting the fiber into the unit packs, and we're cutting the gloves because we have to cut out the spandex wristband, But yeah, they put them in unit packs. And,
Oh, really?
I'm going to run out of unit packs, but yeah, like I said,
Making money, though. Right.
Somebody is.
Sure, well, I'm just saying, maybe cutting the money, it'll reflect. Wow. It'll come back.
A steady job for 15 years. And they call George Reeves Superman. Yeah. So, nothing for tomorrow, man? So now we're just.
I don't know, yeah.
Tomorrow, Thursday?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm hoping he calls me tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it'll be a turnaround because I know, but they would still go to Atlanta no matter what.
At least they would
be like behind the trailer.
Yeah.
The holler. So they want it washed anyway, rain or shine.
Right.
So they'll pull it into the dock. I'll wash it in there.
Oh,
we're good.
back.
Which is kind of cool.
Oh, heck yeah, man.
I don't like it being tight, but
right.
I can't complain. I'm in a NASCAR garage. Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
What is wrong with that?
I'd like to know.
Yeah. Yeah, this
my, my dad's got this album, by the way.
Yeah, this is Van on the Run. And
yeah.
The music on the movie. The,
yeah. What movie?
James Bond.
Oh, yeah.
Live and Let Die. Yeah. But yeah.
Yeah, it is. That's why I need to come out my tux.
Oh, and what's gonna happen then?
Then I'm gonna be like, just stand there because there's really nothing for me to play.
Why?
I could do a harmonica on this, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
Right there. Jane Bond, ladies and gentlemen.
You have to play with it, but it'd be different, you know. But, I didn't, you know, that's how. Side,
yeah.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're on.
Well, yeah. We just won't replace one instrument with another.
Yeah. Just make it, yeah, do a cover with it, you know?
She's in a
prayer thing. So.
But you get your little umbrella, didn't you?
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, man.
He's singing in the rain or he's walking in the rain.
I wish it was live. I would give a shout out to one of my buddies, Kenny or Bill, that worked for Yellow Cab. Be like, give me a holler, y'all. Pick me up, I owe you $7 later.
Oh.
Yeah. They know I would.
No cops.
No, it didn't happen.
No.
No Travaglio.
What's that?
No Travaglio.
No.
No? You said no dinero.
What? You said no work, no money?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
See?
Right. So what's next?
On what?
I don't know. Tomorrow, the rest of your day. What?
I know.
Hey, when's that, your little...
Birthday's this weekend.
I know, but when's the ice... Oh, we have to do the ice bucket thing, right?
I'll know after my birthday, I'm going to check.
Right.
And then we'll do it right after this, yeah. Like Monday or Tuesday or something like that.
Next month again?
Yeah, man. It's got to be up to my birthday.
Right.
Yeah,
when's your birthday?
Saturday.
Sounds like...
What?
No. That was a dark day.
Yeah. What's a dark day? What, the day I was born? Is that what you're trying to say?
You figure it out.
I can't believe it. That's horrible.
Well, I'm just like a French Marine right now.
What? Do you really want this exposed?
Yeah, why not? You can see his receding hairline.
I need a haircut.
Once again, yeah.
Feel better. Started feeling like, get him, Rock! Right. You know, he always wore the toboggan.
Yeah,
the old man.
I'm that guy on you got the YouTube, the Edge, or whatever. Toboggan. Yeah. There you go, Eddie.
What song is this?
What? I think it's the second. First song on side two of the record.
Oh, yeah. You can
make this whole damn thing work out. Yeah, it's kind of hard. Yeah. So what did you do today? Anything?
Not really. I mean, watch TV, be honest with you. I was on my phone.
Sounds like me too, man.
I played a couple casino games.
Right.
Yeah. I was up, then I probably took them off because I come up here.
Right.
Recorded this morning for it. I'm going to upload them later.
Oh, tomorrow's Thursday.
Yeah. I got my PO tomorrow.
No, because tomorrow, like at 6 a.m., I've got movie channel 46-4 and the free TV. They've got like all day they put your noir movies.
Oh, do they?
Oh, yeah.
The N-O-R, N-O-I-R.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like those, man.
Yeah, because I always have. This guy Payne got knocked off.
Really?
That was his name, Payne. Yeah.
No way.
And then, oh boy.
I myself.
One should only hope, but you know, why? I mean, he could fall down the steps, you know, as close as that's supposed to be.
Yeah.
W.P. Davis. my side. Tell you what,
you and him remind me of Elmer Fudd chasing Daffy Duck and the rabbit.
Bugs Bunny.
Bugs Bunny, yeah. Old Mr. Rabbit, yeah.
No, but I did get nervous that one night when I had him. I had the big East Wing hammer tomorrow. I put it. This whole hammer might have broke off.
It's the rod of Thor.
Well, the damn shit.
It weighed 190 pounds.
Well, I mean, the hammer weighed more than his arm. His forearm or something.
It was like an anchor.
Skinny as whippy, sickly looking at his. God bless.
Go to hand him something, and he goes to grab it with both hands, and he says, and as soon as you let it go, he's like, man, give me a second.
Yeah,
like, exactly. And as soon as you give him a second, you let go, he's like, yeah. And he drags out, like,
we're dragging it.
Yeah. Are you that, what are you living off of, broth? Yeah. I mean, what is wrong with you?
Well, I don't know.
He goes, that's why he don't walk anymore in the wind. Brady's gonna get blown out in front of a car.
Well, he's got that little hood over his jacket.
Yeah. It's like a sail.
Yeah, he's a sail, yeah.
Because he's like a feather.
Oh, shit. Oh, like I said, but yeah, that's pain for you.
It won't be long, man. We'll be walking around. The only thing around here that is crazy, you know what I'm talking about when I'm saying this.
Right, yeah.
Those long green worms that come down off of these. And like out of nowhere, like even across the street, in the middle of the street where there's no trees, no power lines or nothing, there's green worms floating, like just coming down. Right. Like, it's crazy.
That's so exciting.
It's crazy, man.
Because when I first moved out here, the summer of 1995, I thought they were just overproductive spiders. But there's like a little blonde-headed girl who lived in the front house. I lived in the above the garage in the rear. But she said, "Oh no, they're like worms and all."
Yeah, just little worms, you know.
And then I remember Mr. Crab saying, "Oh, cut that because they'll take over a part of a tree, you know."
They will.
And then destroy it. Yeah, but it did. But yeah. But yeah.
Oh yeah.
I'll tell you what, I went over there Monday, there was still water flowing across this front yard.
Man, we got water flooded around back, man. Yeah. In between Robin and Mom and Dad's, it's flooded. See?
Well, because, you know, I sure scrub the culvert drains it instantly. It drains down and around.
I mean, you don't understand. It was like, when I woke up this morning, went on the balcony and smoked a piece of a cigar.
Yeah.
I looked out, there were two people fishing. I swear to you, yes.
Well,
yes. One guy was putting his boat in.
Right.
I'm like, I think we have a water problem.
Oh, yeah.
Gabe Morton sitting over the parking lot drinking coffee.
Right. There was like a... It was like a nice little stream.
Really? See, it's going to do that for days, man.
That would be at least 3.5 acres back, because there's a quarter acre that's still wooded, but yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, back in suit, yeah, that's neat. Yeah, it just drains like, wow, like a little creek, you know, yeah.
Man, Steve, when I was in Yakinville.
Right.
In around 2005.
Yeah.
I went
Yakinville,
up,
okay, yeah.
I was in... Anyway, on a 110-acre farm, right?
Right.
Up there. And me and the other guys, we went exploring. Like, I was up there for so long. I was up there for almost like 8-9 months, something like that.
Right.
Anyway, I was up there, and we went exploring one time on this farm. We went like out past where the 110-acre was.
Right.
Into this wooded part, and there were streams. There were cows that come through there and stuff. We'd go fish and whatever.
It was a junior's farm?
No, man. Actually, you know what this was? This is where in the, let's see, 30s, 40s, and 50s, up to the 60s, and I think 70s,
right
around the late 70s, early 80s,
right.
They sold it. They sold the Boys and Girls Cub Scouts and Girl Scouts.
Right.
Where the state would gather, this was where they would meet. One side of these lakes.
It's like a jamboree.
Yeah, and it was cabins and stuff like that. Yeah. And then where the guys were, they had a cabin. Well, they kept the cabin. The cabin's amazing, man. It's humongous.
Yeah.
Anyway, we went exploring, and I started seeing these trees that were humongous. Some of the limbs on these trees would be half as big as round as right here, man. I'd never seen anything like it hardly up until I went to South Carolina.
That's a very mature tree.
Oh, yeah.
You ever seen a redwood?
No, I would love to.
Oh, boy.
No, I'm not. Actually, I told you I saw a documentary that National Geographic put out about where they were measuring the biggest. They wanted to finally distinguish the tallest redwood there was.
Right, yeah.
So they went searching and looking, and they did the most state-of-the-art digital with the drone stuff, like measuring. Well, they would spend the night sometime in these trees. Well, they chose one that was really big.
Right.
Well, they noticed halfway up, climbing up, they were going to spend the night in this tree.
Right.
And that geo crew had filmed, it shook more. And through the night, a storm came through, and it shook so much while they were filming it. Right. These guys were terrified.
Yeah.
So at daybreak, they got down in the storm about 2 or 3 hours after they got away from this tree and were hiking off. They heard and filmed the loudest crash ever. It was an actual filming of a redwood falling.
Right. I've heard that story. Yeah.
Yep, man, it was crazy.
It is, yeah. You're talking about that, yeah.
Oh, yeah. This is a great song.
They got damn lucky they got a tree.
Exactly, man. This is like when they found the crystal cave. It's these crystals the size of houses, basically.
I know, but look, if the good Lord, good God Eddie, if the good Lord wanted us to live in trees, then he'd give us wings.
Exactly, there's
and
a clue.
And there's, so now.
I had a man tell me one time, Eddie, if you really want to be a good Christian, you wouldn't wear the earrings. That's why he said, because if the Lord wanted you to have earrings, he wouldn't give you holes in here.
Well, I
said, did he give your wife holes? No. Well, there you go.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. Be smarter than that.
Right, please. Man, you need a haircut, man.
I need a horrible haircut, man.
Yeah, man.
I'm this close to doing it myself.
Well, I don't know. Yeah, you want to come summertime, you know. The way you shave Cody like a sheep, you know. But
I don't want that. I want it faded, though. I want it shaved. I want a bald-headed fade. You know, where I got this little bit of hair here, and the rest of it's faded to a bald head, to about right here down.
Yeah.
But it needs to be done. I just can't do it myself.
You got the little fad for it.
It's too much. I need all of it done. I need it saved.
Yeah. Well, do something. What happened?
I have no idea.
We got an audio problem here?
I guess you do. Easy.
Eat
it. Mother, shut your mouth. He's a bad mama, shut your mouth.
I know. What happened here?
I don't know, man.
We lost power. Did you sit on the damn thing?
I did not sit. How would I sit on it? I've been perfectly still.
I have no idea. Like I say, you...
Oh, my Lord.
...would have some way of...
Why is it me?
Well, it's not me.
Well, it wouldn't be me.
But, you know... Like I say... What are we looking for? For the,
What song?
Well,
I'll look it.
I can't see.
I got it. I can.
There we go. I got some light.
Here, you want me to throw some light on?
No, I got to put it on.
You're going to skip ahead.
No, we're just going to put on 7. Oh. But oops.
Yeah.
We're so sorry. There you go.
And
this was on the
Please, man, don't be mad.
No, did I find a cassette tape of that? Yeah.
Oh, you had a cassette tape of this?
Well, I've got it on the side of the road, Eddie.
No way. Oh, that's what you were saying.
Yeah, like I said,
I thought you said you found an album.
No. I guess, tape player, and pull it out and just threw out the window.
Right.
And then on the side of the road.
Right.
And I took it home and I wound it up on this
picture. Okay.
And then it was this record that someone had recorded,
on a cassette, yeah.
Right, exactly.
Or the cassette version of it.
Right, yeah.
We're so sorry, but we have nothing all day.
That sounds like
we're
you.
So sorry.
You ain't done it. Bloody thing all day. With the kettle or something.
If anything should happen, we'll be sure you
look and see if it's snowing, Steve.
Wizard Zari,
Uncle Abbott.
Uncle Eddie.
Rejoice. That's rejoice around here.
We have to have penance if we don't say the right thing.
I don't know, but like I said, we
got uh-oh. This is Rodney when he gets up there to behind the
yeah.
Deedle deedle.
Oh, wow.
That's Rodney. Deedle deedle deedle. If I was doing a comic, that's what I would have say.
No way. That's cool, yeah. Oh, bless.
I knew things were getting serious when he inspected the marquee.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, this is good.
Oh, yeah. But now
I don't think you could have picked a better album to play for this night.
Well, it's a great sense, but yeah, it's still, it's a good collection.
Good compilation, yeah.
Right, yeah. Compilation, collection, whatever, Edith.
I didn't mean it like that, jackass.
Wait a minute.
You know I missed it.
Right. Well, you know, I was like, whatever,
Edith. I know. Actually, I saw his chair at the Smithsonian.
Yeah?
Good, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. And the ruby slippers from The Wizard of Oz.
Right.
She died of an overdose. Yeah.
No, my boy.
The chick that played in The Wizard of Oz, man. What was the name of the actress who played Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz? What was her name?
That was Liza Minnelli's girl.
That was Liza Minnelli's mother. What was her name?
No.
Yes, it was.
Oh, it was Cole. Yeah.
It was her mother.
Right, yeah.
You're like, no.
Yeah.
I know what I'm saying. Anyway, I seen her slippers at Swiss Army.
Right, yeah.
I saw Ollie's glove.
Right.
Yeah, Lou Gehrig's baseball.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Touched the moon rock. Saw Apollo stuff. Yeah. Saw all kinds of things.
Yeah, it must be a mighty big place. Yeah.
It's changed since then, man. It's decades ago.
Right.
I also went on old Ironside, George Washington's original ship that they still have restored at the Baltimore Harbor.
Yeah.
I got to go on it, and I went on a, I think a, either a Vietnam version or a World War II submarine that I got to tour. Yeah. Which is cool. At the Baltimore Harbor, yeah. Been to Lincoln Memorial. Watch a lot of it.
Yeah.
I love it. Like Onyx and Cemetery.
My Judy Garland.
Judy, that's it. Yeah. You're, Steve is like wicked. I know technology's great, but it's not as quick as Steve.
Well,
you were like, what is the name of that computer system that they created, Google, whoever? I'm not trying to say anything, but whoever created that system to play the world's smartest man at chess,
right.
He beat it. He beat it.
Right, yeah.
So, yeah. You can't beat human. A computer can only be programmed with what humans give it. So only human technology is.
Right,
You can't download quicker than a human can think.
Well, every now and then I hit the run-off flush of the rabbit dog, so I beat the computer.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I love this organ. We're going to get it. And he's talking about getting high on the music, and somewhere in the deep south, there was a minister saying, "Don't you listen to that Paul McCartney talking about getting high.
Good God Almighty.
The King James Version says, no, you don't want to get high."
Oh, yeah.
It's music. Feel good. Come on, man.
Right.
What is
it? Well, what was
that? Uh-oh. This is one of my favorite songs by Lil Steve.
Yeah.
This is one of my favorite.
Oh, yeah.
Because my pop used to like, I told you he had this.
Yeah.
Like, he has this greatest hits, apparently.
Yeah.
Because this is all I heard.
Right.
And I love it.
Yeah.
I wish the band would cover this.
Right.
They could play this.
Well, then you could play the hoop to do on your harmonica.
What about me on the piano?
No, on the harmonica.
Yeah. No piano though?
No. Just get some good bass.
Yeah. With everybody else, yeah.
And then,
someone
just strumming.
When would I come in?
What, you mean on the flute?
Flute, man.
Listen to the damn song. Right?
I'm trying to figure out when the harmonica. Bobby can do that.
Good. Right. Just right there, Eddie.
Yeah. I can just trade it for harmonica, Sister Susie.
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
My brother Michael.
Yeah, man. Well, damn it. Wait a minute, Eddie. And then... when you play a higher key of
Yeah. I dig it.
Yeah.
Man, you done like Steve, you're always five star. If Rolling Stone was to like do a study of all the people in the United States, would like take data where they know what people like, like what you bought, whatever, you'd be up there in the echelon of like music knowledge.
Right. Well,
for real. No, I'm being honest with you.
Right, Rumpus.
I give you credit, man. Really, like, I know people know music. You know what I'm saying? So.
Well, just play what the people want to hear. You know.
It's not just that. You're tasting that music, though. Yeah. I mean, you. I don't know. It's only what I want to hear.
Right.
What you play, which is like rare.
Right.
I can do this with like Mike. My brother,
yeah.
Marissa, and obviously like her dad, because her dad, because Marissa knows this stuff. Chris, my baby brother,
right.
Carmen. Other than that, well, dad, mom.
What are you talking about?
Like this type of music,
all,
which is what I dig. Like
right.
All the music that you play, that genre.
Right.
Like we cover everything, but still.
I try.
Yeah.
I try.
I think of this song when I think of the other night.
What happened?
You got a phone call.
Oh,
who it was? You know,
right,
like,
yeah.
I'm like, oh, love of God.
Yeah.
They could have waited.
Yeah.
I'm talking about throwing ice water on a plane.
How we scrap the whole thing in?
Yep.
Yeah.
I swear. That was your call too. You're like, hey.
Yeah.
Susan, stop. You're like, hey,
well,
stop it, scrap it. I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
Which is perfectly fine.
But tonight so far so good. You know, no phone calls, no pain knocking on the door.
You got nobody coming over here.
Well,
busting my balls.
Bothering
me. Calling me,
bothering
me. I wish we had never. I love the Doors so much. I wish we never played.
Yeah.
LA
Will.
Right. Right now we need.
Yeah.
I need a brand new.
Right.
It doesn't bother me.
Yeah.
But this is God only knows this is great though.
But no, but the guy.
This is my love.
Yeah. But the guy in number three, he's fine.
Oh yeah.
But pain is such a.
You talking about Ooga Ooga? Yeah,
not
he,
a dollar.
Yeah, then you
for the one time he knocked on the door, wanted the rent. And like, oh, pain is not due until like 3 days from now. Oh, and he got a dollar, you know.
He shows up like 2 days into the week before rent's due.
Right.
And he says, like, ask Steve for it. Steve's like, I'll give it to you at the end of the week when it's due. And he's like, oh, okay. And he tries to hop over, looking over Steve like, oh, I'm about like Eddie. You got a dollar.
Yeah.
Steve's like, we don't have no money.
No gods,
man. Yeah. No mas. Slammed.
I gotta say.
Because you know what? We're not that dumb. Just, here's the thing.
Right.
I would be more apt.
Right.
In my spirit. If you're trying to change my mood and spirit to where I would be more apt to lend you money, you would be more... It would behoove you more if you just were honest and said, sit the door up, but like, man, hey, y'all, I ain't trying to bother y'all. I know y'all like
hanging out,
but
no,
y'all
but
don't have a dollar.
I know, but.
So, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah,
no.
I know, but that one that he knocked on the door, he's all, oh boy, yeah, Christian Mission once again paid my power bill, you know, then.
And then
he looks around.
He looks over the same and says, you got 75 cents. And
right.
And then I said,
what?
No,
like,
I don't. And then Steve said,
blam,
no,
yeah.
We ain't got no change either.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, yeah. It's like, man,
that's my
man.
Point, exactly.
Yeah.
I would be more apt
right.
than if he, as soon as he knocked on the door, he's like, man, Eddie. Like that first night when he said, man, as soon as he knocked on the door and you're at the door, like, man, I ain't trying to bother y'all. I know y'all.
Right.
But please don't be mad at me. Man, don't neither one of y'all got like a dollar I can borrow.
Yeah.
At least to me, I would most likely say
yeah.
no. Again,
right. Oh, yeah. No
but even, and look, and even the second time we knocked
yeah.
on the door, and he went on to spiel. One was about the woman,
right?
You know, the police bottle. That was a lie. Then the other one was about how he was scamming another,
right. oh,
you
yeah.
know, another
yeah.
great
yeah.
ice.
Right.
Anyway, yeah. And then ask me, I would be more apt if he'd just knock on the door and said, man, you ain't got 75 cents, do you, man? I'm like, I ain't trying to get a bump, but you got 75 cents, yeah. Please.
Right.
But instead, to go on this spiel, he always has to have a spiel. That's my thing.
Yeah.
And here's what bothers me, is that he thinks I could fall for it, or that you could. Yeah, we're that dumb.
Oh, no. What was that one time he called?
Here's the thing, a man who breaks his collarbone sitting down normally doesn't have a good filter.
No.
That's Captain Kangaroo says to Mr. Green Jeans. Mr. Green Jeans.
Yeah.
There's your lesson today. Yeah. As we just give it on over to Mr. Rogers, and he's right. Got the same lesson.
No.
You don't listen to a man that breaks his collarbone sitting down.
What?
Oh, boy. Yeah, usually doesn't pan out.
He looks rough.
I'm telling you, man, time has not been good on him.
No.
How can he possibly be fossilized as a human being?
Well, he's only, 60? But looks like he's like
I swear to you, it's Methuselah's either first or second cousin. I can't remember what he said. Because he actually did the Ancestry.com, and they said one of his immediate relatives was Methuselah. So it had to be a sibling.
Yeah. Wayne looks.
They said Wayne is like nearly 937 years old genetically, but but earthly, like he's only like 60,
right.
61.
Yeah, but it's a good family resemblance. Yeah, you know.
He's kin to Dobby.
Oh God, Gollum. That's what I'm saying. It's a good family resemblance. You know, like I was saying, God Almighty.
They've got him quarantined down here at the Mooresville.
Yeah.
What is the reserves over here at the armory?
Right, yeah.
They got him locked in the armory. Yeah. Like E.T.
Oh, yeah.
Feeding him food.
What?
Man, this is dropping.
Right.
This reminds me of when I was still working for Scott, the guy striping parking lots.
Yeah.
And I was having some problems at home. It's just, it was too much. I need to move out. So I had money. So come find out, I moved out with Christopher's mom over at her house over at the corner. And she would let me use her car sometimes in the afternoon, especially on like days. I'd go make some bills and I'd go through the I don't mind saying this now, this is decades ago. But anyway, I forgot a little bit of whatever. But I am running, and I have the nicest white sports taco you've ever seen, Steve. Leather interior. I can hit the traction control and go around that loop at the point like I was at Bristol. I'm telling you, one night I come through, this is in the 90s, or like mid. This is before 2005, so obviously you know what era this was. So I come through trucking, you know, and it just dawned on me. See what she does. I do, man. I don't even fish tell her. I go through there like 40 miles an hour through that
woods.
And Christopher is, you know, Tammy's son, the one, you know, happened to come through and he's like turquoise pickup in the air. And I see him, he's like, oh my Lord. You know, so, man, we had fun, man. We'd go back over to the house, and I'd be like, ugh. And then he would be like, hey, Mom wanted to know if you wanted to eat with me over the point.
Right.
She'd get it. So all you had to do is say, I'm going to say a number.
Right.
You want to step out? Yeah. over the point. You just say the number, and you're good. They just assume you're good. But you just wear a collar, shirt, maybe a jacket. Man, they had some of the best food, Steve. Even if it wasn't on the menu, you could order whatever you wanted. Like, I always like to get like a little bit of lamb and some beef and maybe a lobster tail or something.
Right.
But then I would start out with the cob salad, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I look over and Christopher's gone down 8 or 9. When you order a cherry coke, by the way, they use cherries, they crust, they make their own like cherry coke, right? And it's like 4, 5, 6, something like that. A drink. It's been down 8 or 9. As soon as we get there. Like it ain't nothing.
Right.
And I'm like thinking, I'm gonna get drunk later on, so I'm gonna eat now. And like,
oh, yeah.
Boom! I would eat, and I love Tammy, his mom. I love his dad. So even though she struggles still. But they had good, like, so they had good lamb. They had like a rack of lamb.
Right.
It was really, or like a leg of lamb, like they would cut it for you.
Right.
It was so good, Steve, I swear to you.
Yeah.
I mean, the only thing you could get better and more fresh was if you were in like Istanbul. And you were shaving off a piece, or Morocco,
yeah.
And shaving off a piece off the wheel. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Like fresh, like just tender.
Oh,
I know people are against the karma, don't like it. My dad cooks the Easter, but
yeah.
It's delicious.
Yeah.
I run my mouth.
Right. What happened now?
I just talk too much, I think.
Well, don't run out of gas now.
Oh, I'm not. That's the problem, Steve. I just said I talk too much, man.
Yeah.
You're encouraging me. I don't like this.
Why? It's your show.
It's not my show. It says Uncle Eddie and Steve show. Capital letters.
Right, yeah.
Uncle Eddie.
Yeah.
Small letters and.
Right.
Capital letters Steve.
Yeah.
Show.
Right.
Duh, actually, by the way, capital letters.
Right, yeah. We,
now,
yeah.
That's the.
Right, yeah.
My channel. Or our channel.
Right.
Actually, listen, this is our channel, even on that.
Right.
You don't have a phone hooked up.
No.
You ever get one?
Well,
oh, Marissa got a laptop.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she's going to go to school.
Yeah?
Yeah, she's going to do online school, which is great. Good for her, man. She's, like, really doing good, man.
Yeah, what's she going to study?
She was doing the architect CAD system.
Right. Oh, yeah.
She likes to draw and stuff, so,
yeah.
Which would be right up her alley. That's,
yes.
And I've been telling her all this time, do this.
Yeah.
And she got it, so
that's
great, man. I'm so proud of her.
Yeah.
I swear.
No, when she came up here one night, she had a little paint, so she painted a little picture.
Oh, yeah, she's good.
Yeah,
she?
Yeah, watercolor paint. Watercolor.
I ought to call her. She asked me how I was doing earlier today. I like this. I said, I'm good. I'm just chilling out, watching TV. I think I was watching, I watched a documentary of one band. Oh, my Lord.
Well, you tell me.
I don't know.
Well,
yeah, obviously, I think you're
right.
I should be wearing some either Lederhosen or a kilt and rocking with my big pint.
And a kilt playing bagpipes, yeah.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Exactly. Got the big drum.
Yeah.
Somewhere in the highlands of Scotland.
Right, yeah, man, sure.
Man, yeah. Some of the strongest, those strongman contests they have, like those, the highlands.
Yeah.
Actually, Queen Elizabeth goes to the contest there.
Right, yeah.
Because she considers that like a summer home, like, and I don't blame her. You know, like, there's good food there, come on now.
Yeah.
It's great. It's not bland, it's not always bland. Like, yeah, it's good. I actually knew it. When I lived at Myrtle Beach, actually with Christopher, we were living at the apartments in Myrtle Beach. The neighbor upstairs, he was a young dude, just got out of veterinary school, and he was a local veterinarian there in Myrtle Beach, and his wife was Scotland, because that's where he went to get his license. And it's still great food, man. It's good. Good stew.
That's
your world. Oh, yeah. That was cool. It was a cool time. It was like, you know, ups and downs.
Yeah,
you're great guys, and you're horrible. Like, where am I doing?
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah. I wouldn't trade it now.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's about it for tonight, man.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
The last song on the record, yeah.
Anyway, y'all, that you seen the album.
Yeah.
So, I hope you have a great night.
All right.